Guten Tag. Hallo. We are currently in Calvin Park. Hi, today I ran out of spare paper while writing my pen pal mail, so passed by a stationery store and bought 3 writing pads on a whim. This is the most expensive one. This is around just over $3. It's branded, it's Kikuyo. It says it's a writing pad. High class, silk cool. The rainbow comes and goes, and lovely is the rose. The moon doth with delight look round her when the heavens are bare. Right, expensive writing pad. I think this will work. I'm not sure, because the rest of these are under $1. I have this airline airmailing writing pad, and I also have this Gladiator special quality writing pad, trademark number 101. With weird stuff on the back. I haven't opened these, so I have no idea what's gonna happen. Today I've got a Pilot Parallel 6.0 for wetness. On the other end of the italic scale, I have the Parsons Essential Italics, fine italic nib, a Twisby, my EF with some ink in it, and for stress testing, I also have my dip nib that I was writing with recently. Anyway, let's go from cheapest first. Okay, this one. The paper is crap quality, I assure you. Fresh paper smell. Alright, airline air mailing writing pad. I have no hopes whatsoever, but considering how much I bought these for, I don't have any expectations either. Airline air mailing writing pad. Oh my god, it works. Airline air mail writing pad. Someone's calling me on my phone. Whoops. Sorry. Cut. I haven't flipped it over, but so far, this is amazing. This is no feathering whatsoever. We have to draw an aeroplane. How do you draw planes? I can't draw planes for my life. Things are weird. And I know nothing about aerodynamics, so this plane will flop. Anyway, some random perspective. And it has no engine, so it doesn't matter. If we flip it over, okay, obviously there's some bleed through considering how thin this paper is. You can run over the other side, but that was with my really wet Pilot Parallel 6mm. Yeah, some dip. Conclusion. Already. We're jumping to conclusions. Oh no, I think already. My awful flex script in action. I think again. When I use this dip nib, it is a bit rough. It's holding up, but just barely. Dot. The paper didn't tear, but I can hear it about to tear. The other inks are totally fine though, which is pretty cool. Especially that thick italic nib. Conclusion. I would just call it a pass, let's be honest. It's a pass. If we take a look at the other side, obviously, this paper is really thin. So, oh dear. Well, great for everything except dip nibs and like heavy flexing. Otherwise, it looked fine on the top. So, I'd still call it a pass since I wouldn't expect anything to work on these with a lot of ink at feathers. So there we go. Next up, we have some marginally more expensive Gladiator with a strange horizontal ruling. I'm going to subject this to the same amount of abuse. Gladiator writing pad, special quality Gladiator. I'm going to have to draw a Gladiator afterwards. The coloring's a bit weird though. I'm not really used to red lined paper. Gladiator.
I
can see a little bit of feathering there already. Gladi. Four. This is a Gladiator writing pad. Very noticeable feathering if we flip it over and bleed through, but this paper is so thin I'd only write on one side anyway. What does it say? Special quality? Huh. Very dubious special quality. My Twisby tends a little thin. I mean not thin. Dry. Special. I'm gonna put that in quotation. Special. Do I have to draw a Gladiator? Fine. Awful hilt. There you go. Dodgy. This ink is the very bright violet Pansy ink from J. Herbin. This is a Roshizuku, that's fine. This is just the pilot ink mix, the pilot parallel mixing ink. Final test. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. No more flexing. As long as I'm not flexing it. Oh no. As long as I'm not flexing, it still feathers like nothing. Conclusion. It absorbs a lot more ink than usual. Passable. Safer pens. Oh my god, the flex bit. You can also hear it scratch, but that's also a bit of the nib. Steel nib. And yeah, the second page is better than the first. The back, however, is a mess. That's fine. So this is Gladiator. This is also around $1. I think it's cool to have a horizontal lined a landscape pad though. Finally, the one I have most hope for is this Kakuyo. Kakuyo being a Japanese brand made in Japan. The rest were, I didn't even check. The rest didn't even want to talk about where they were from. I have high hopes for this. Silk, cool, high class, that's very nice. Very nice H there. The pad feels really nice. The paper is much smoother than the others. Please don't let me down. H. So far so good on the safe pen. Now for the monstrosity. So cool. Some sneak peek. Oh wow. Not showing you. Not till later. Very nice to write on. it has no picture, so I don't have to draw anything. High class cookie writing pad. It's very smooth. Smoother than the other two anyway. And when I use my nib, I'm currently using a Nikko G. Ooh. And then, Kong. As you can see, the ink is holding very well. Conclusion. Dot. Oh no. Why did I write W? Oh, okay. This is the most awful, wonderful I've ever written. Need more ink. Wonderful. Not my writing, of course, but the paper itself. Unlike the others, you couldn't even hear any scratching sounds when I was using my dip nib. And the backside is completely, well, pretty much no bleed through, no feathering, very smooth experience. Cost 3 times as much as everything else, but it's still really cheap. Today we have reviewed Airline Writing Pad. I'm gonna cheat. Gladiator writing pad and some Kikuyo Silco writing pad. The Silco comes out top, hands down. It's also 3 times more expensive, but still at a very cheap price range. If I use this, with the normal pen, I could probably write on the other side, even if they have no lining whatsoever. I suppose what I'd probably do is just doodle on the other side. The cheapest one, the Airline Air Mailing Writing Pad, is really thin paper compared to this. It's far more thin. Comes a close second, though I wouldn't recommend using dip nibs. And the Gladiator is abysmal with regards to most of the writing. Lots of feathering. A little bit of bleed through onto like the next page. But I will give it credit for being the only paper which is horizontally aligned, just sort of unique. And now I have more paper. All I wanted to do was like just buy some paper to write some sort of replies on, but I suppose this was a very, very inexpensive venture into the sort of strange, cheap writing pads you can get at my local stationery store.